Hello, I'm Mr. Rajar, a retired lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist and I preach Christianity, Sikhism, and real Islam, which is Sharia free. And here I'm rendering exposition of John 1, verse 47 to 51. Holy Gospel of our Supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., delivered by the First Anointed Christ, which in Punjabi, my native language, we call Satguru Jesus, of the highest living God, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, that dwells in his most beautiful temple of God. This is the one, our physical body, created not by the human hands, but by the demiurge potter, the lord of the nature, a greatest artist, Yahweh, Brahma, Khudah. This Yahweh brings the Jewish, he is the Jewish God. Yahweh brings Abram from Iraq area to settle in Middle East as Adam, Sarah as Eve, and they were given the promised land, the Garden of Eden. They are very instructive. And here in Middle East, that Christ Jesus has given us the practical demonstration and everything, which is very good, etc., represented by angel, the prophet Elijah, John the Baptist. He worked for Yahweh, and Christ Jesus came to work for Elohim. And it is called Harmandir. This is called Harmandir. Emmanuel, God is with us, according to St. John 1, 47 to 51 verses. So, God is with you if your heart is clean. And here, Jesus is going to give you the quality of the heart which we want, is in his one of the laborer, Nathanael. And I will come to this one. Jesus saw Nathanael coming toward him and said of him, "Here is a true child of Israel, salt of Abraham, and faithful to Yahweh. What is inside is outside, like the heart of a little child, free of hypocrisy." That is what Jesus wanted. He was the ideal laborer for the vineyard of our supernatural Father. Jesus had no disciple. The root of the word disciple is discipline, and the rabbis, Pharisees, Sadducees, they disciplined the natural once-born boys by teaching them the moral of Moses, and they had disciples. So disciples study scripture, and the workers, laborers, working in the Royal Vineyard, they go by the gospel, learned through logical reasoning, which is the top root of the tree of life. And here is tree of life. The tree of life. And this is scripture, which is for the disciples of the rabbis and Pharisees, Sadducees. And this is called milk. And here is the top root, which is the gospel, oral Torah. That is what Jesus came to deliver. This oral Torah comes from Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, our supernatural Father. And this is the creation of Yahweh, Brahma Khudah, that you can see with your two naked eye. So this you can't see, this perceive. This is see. That's why Jesus said, they see the dead letters of the oral, and they see the dead letters of the written Torah, but they do not perceive this oral Torah, which the Samaritan people perceived, because they were faithful to Abraham, faithful to Yahweh, salt of the earth. They recognize Christ Jesus, but not those temple priests. When Jesus told them that he is the Christ, they took stones to kill him. Whereas the Samaritans, they took them, whole village came to welcome him and took them into their village where he stayed for 2 days, ironing out any doubts in their hearts. They did not need more than 2 days, that was enough. Whereas among the chosen people among whom he came, they loved darkness. He spent all his life, and then at the end, they put him to die as the Lamb of God, innocent person. Much more you can learn if you are interested. So, hypocrisy, Samaritans were of this type, of the type of nuns here. There is no duplicity or hypocrisy in him. A perfect laborer for the Royal Vineyard of our Supernatural Father Elohim Allah Parbrahm, but was inside, was outside, like the little child. So he had the heart of a child, but he was grown up, sensible person. That's what means when you are born, you are a child, then what is inside is outside. As you grow up, then the parents or the surrounding teach you, you can cheat that person like this. The Jewish people, to the Gentile, because they were not cheating people, they were honest, and they were calling them Goshi Koppa. Goshi Koppa means they have a head of a stone. They can't cheat. They can't make money. Those who were making money, they were good people. Like the American Jews who control Mammon and media, and that is what they are doing now in the world. This you can see, a Jewish man putting on the American flag with the sickle, David's cross, and he is bringing bloodshed from all these countries. This is created by a deputy head of the Green Party in Parliament in Britain. So the parliamentarians know, but they can't speak. If they speak, the Mammon and media pull them down, so they are frightened. So you have to fight against this word. So laborer for the Royal Vineyard of our Supernatural Father Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc. Nathanael said to him, "How do you know me?" Jesus answered and said to him, "Before Philip called you," because he was omniscient, you know. So here he is giving him the example of these powers. "Before Philip called you, I saw you under the fig tree." Nathanael answered him, "Rabbi, you are the omniscient Son of God." So he then knew, as Nicodemus knew, unless you are Son of God, you cannot perform all those miracles. So this Nathanael, like Nicodemus, was clean-hearted. "You are the royal king of Israel that governs our hearts." You are the kings. Kings govern this flesh. And this flesh works for Mammon to eat. And they take tax. So they are the kings. Emperor will take you more tax. Whereas the royal king is of our heart. Of our heart he gives to us. He doesn't take money out of us. So he gives the gospel treasures to us. Free, freely receive, freely they give. No money. Whereas those people who study scripture as they go in the university, they have to pay fees, money. When they pay money, when they come out, they make money like a solicitor or anything with a dog collar on, and they are cheating people. So you can see where you stand. In Jesus, we are royal priest of our heart and not of the dead scripture. Jesus answered and said to him, "Do you believe because I told you that I saw you under the fig tree, you will see that if you believe that one, you know, that what I told you and you said, like Nicodemus, unless you are from God, you can't perform these miracles. Then Jesus said, you will see greater things than this. That means more supernatural things. And he said to him, Amen, Amen. I say to you, you will see the sky open to reach the palace of our supernatural Father, Elohim Allah Parbrahm, which is above heaven. And the people, you know, when they say, where is God or anything? Oh, it's in heaven. And heaven is a thing which you can see with two naked eyes. All that you see belong to Yahweh. Our supernatural Father is above heaven. The heaven is the footstool of our supernatural Father. So that's why Jesus, when he was baptized in water, then the heaven opened up. Heaven opened up, that means above heaven. And that was our supernatural Father where he is. And this is his palace. This is a Yahweh. John the Baptist holding scripture. Prophet Elijah, my God is Yahweh. Yahweh is the creator of all that you can see with two naked eyes. So he is dealing with heaven. Heaven, whatever you see with two naked eyes. So heaven is concerned, this you can see, but soul you can't see. You have to perceive. So, this is of heaven and hell concerned, not my soul. So, here he holds scripture, where Luke 16, verse 16, law and prophets were till John the Baptist. So, law means the Nicodemus type people, priests who were honest, they were applying law and they were doing justice. But when they became crook, they became hypocrites, usurping the properties of the widows and all that, you know, they were doing crook. And then Christ come, you know, because they were hue and cry in the society. The honest people were hue and cry, poor people. The Jews were cheating the Gentiles. If a Jew cheat a Jew, then they go to a rabbi. If a Jew cheat a Gentile, another Jew cannot be a witness against the Jew. And that Jew will take him to the court, and where the person judge, he can bribe him and get that Gentile grounded down very well. That's why Jesus said, if somebody is taking you to court, try to settle the thing with him. When he take you to court, he will hand you to the police and the court official. They will put you in jail. That's where you will end. So those Gentiles, they were so much suppressed by the crook Jewish people that they were begging our supernatural Father to send his very son. And that is why the Christ come. When there is too much dishonesty and injustice in the world, then Christ come. Christ come to set up the rule of righteousness, like Nathanael type of people. What is inside is outside. If judges are like this, we will have peace. No corruption, no fraud. But if the judges are crook, then the people will be crook too. A tree is known by the fruit it bears. So if the fruit is people are cheating, that means the person who is controlling them is a big cheat. Much more you can learn if you are interested. So this is the of heaven. The word of our flesh. Here you have to bury the ego of the flesh. Ego of the flesh, or destroy it as a seed when you put it in the soil, then a plant comes out of it and seed gets destroyed. The identity of the seed then becomes implicit in the plant. And that plant is called twice born. Seed is called once born. So here there is a seed, once born people. When they destroy their ego and turn it into plant, and that plant enters this one, narrow gate. Low and narrow, low for humble and narrow for solitary, like sadhus. And they graft themselves to the true vine, Christ Jesus, to have their daily bread. And here your soul is concerned. This is above heaven. Soul is supernatural, you can't see. So what you cannot see is above heaven. That's why when Jesus was baptized in water, then the heaven opened up. That means the voice came from above heaven, from God. This is my son. Holy Spirit speaks, you know. This is my son, and listen to him. So this is the above. This is the word of sadhus. Here your soul is concerned, not your flesh. So when you die, then your soul is concerned. Here you have the physical death, when you bury the ego. And here your spiritual birth. And here we are all sons. We have one father, and we all sons, and we exercise love called agape. Agape. Here you exercise love called eros. Eros is the love of the flesh which Moses created in the wilderness, making them faithful sons of Abraham and of Yahweh. The promised land became lush green. So, promised land is our Garden of Eden. Then they enter the Garden of Eden, best food they had, but whenever they became unfaithful, they are kicked out. And today they are getting bundled up in Israel for final burning. Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30 is getting fulfilled. They are all tares, unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh, both the people of Isaac and of Ishmael. They have become Hamas and Fatahs and this and that. That is not tribal people. And Jew is the one who is inwardly, not outwardly. When you become Jew outwardly, you can't build your covenant with Abraham. You are unfaithful, but unfaithful Yahweh, what we call sons of Satan, who don't like Christ. In the temple they were sons of Satan, they did not like Christ. When Jesus was with the Samaritan woman, she gave a good discourse. And she told Jesus that you are a prophet. And she knew the spiritual value of Jesus. And when Jesus said, I am the Christ you are looking for, then there was no problem for her to admit that he is the Christ. So as soon as he gave the good news to the Samaritan woman, that Samaritan woman said, you know, you are a prophet. When Christ comes, he will tell us everything. And when Jesus told that he is the Christ, oh, she was so happy. She left everything over there and she went to her village to tell everyone, look, I have found him. But don't believe me. The Christ you have to find through logical reasoning. You have to perceive, not see with the two naked eye. So this is the word of perception. So here we have one Father, and our soul is concerned. The soul is valued by his deeds of mercy. So deeds of mercy are expected from saint. This is the word of saint, and this is the word of angels. Angels and prophets here, saints and Christ here. I preach Christianity. I'm not a Christian, I'm a Christ. Because I belong to this fold here, royal priest. St. Thomas went to India, South India, where people are salt of the earth, sons of man. and they have conscience, and there he preached the gospel. He was known as Christ Thomas, and so were his laborers over there. They were known as Christ, not Christian. Pope went there. He told them, hey, there's only one Christ. You can't call yourself Christ. If I call myself Christ, you know, Pope will come. No, no, you can't be Christ. There's only one Christ, Jesus. He may kill me, but this time is not killing or putting to stake. Nobody can do you. This is the end time. Our Father is protecting me, Supernatural Father. So I don't care. What is inside is outside of me, like Nathanael. So Nathanael was the true skin, new skin, capable of receiving the new wine, childlike heart. Much more I can tell. So here is the world of souls, in which whether you are black or white or anything, that doesn't matter. Here the quality of your heart counts. If your quality of heart is white, white washed, honest like Nathanael, then you enjoy gospel. If you are hypocrite, you can't enter here. Judas Iscariot was hypocrite. He was stealing money from the church purse. And like these dog collar priests in the churches, he was not allowed inside this one. At Last Supper, you know, when Eucharist was served, he was thrown out. Eucharist is the baptism of Jesus in Holy Spirit. He was thrown out. Eucharist was served to 11 who were honest people, not loving money. So that's why when the people joined the Church of God, they sold all their possession to enter that one. Onions and Sephira, they sold it, but they kept back money. One finger in Mammon, one in God. Peter asked them, is that all you got of the sale? Because of the Mammon, they have to tell lie. And that was blasphemy from the core of their heart, which is against Holy Spirit. And Peter killed them on the spot. Won't allow the blasphemers into the church. Today, the very priest in the church with the dog collar, he is not working for God. He is working for Mammon. At the end of the month, he gets Mammon. He does not get gospel. Gospel 3 years only you get. When they are received freely, you give it freely. You don't charge money. But you give to the church, not take money out of the church, as St. Paul stressed. What apply to flesh, the opposite to? What apply to flesh, opposite to the Holy Spirit? Or what apply to priest, the opposite apply to the royal priest? Priest charge money, royal priest they give money. So much more you can learn by through logical reasoning. It's not difficult at all. And he said to him, Amen, Amen. I say to you, you will see the sky opened to reach the palace of our supernatural Father, Father of our souls, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, etc., which is above heaven. Heaven is the footstool of our supernatural Father, and the angels of God ascending and descending on the Son of Man. Angels mean this. Those people, 70 outer circle laborers, they were angels. And they were serving Jesus, you know, they were going two in a pair ahead of Jesus to baptize people in the name of Abraham. And then Jesus will go to deliver to them sermon. Those who are faithful to Abraham, faithful sons of Abraham, they were receiving the gospel truth. Those who were not baptized, they wanted to be Jew outwardly. They were not given the gospel because they can't recognize their secular father. And how can they recognize the spiritual father which is not seen? So let's see, ascending and descending on the Son of Man. Remember that Christ is the Son of Elohim, the middle candle of the menorah. Thus, Lord of the Sabbath, the royal high priest, greater than the prophets and priests. And here is the situation of Jesus in relation to the, you know, the Torah. So here is the kingdom of heaven and hell of the rabbis, which is outside in law and order. And here is the royal kingdom of God, which is inside your heart. That's why Jesus told Pilate, you know, Pilate told him, hey, your people say you are the king. What type of king are you? Then when Pilate asked him, what type of king you are, did Jesus ask, is it this question coming from your own heart or somebody told you? Then Pilate retorted, do you think I'm a Jew? Your own people are saying that you are a king. Then when Jesus explained to him that if my kingdom was of this nature outside, my soldiers would have come to fight against yours, but mine is inside my heart. And when Pilate understood this, that is inside his heart, the royal kingdom, then he went to the Jews to tell him, hey, he has done nothing wrong. You are just jealous of him. But they shouted more and more, and today you can see the demonstration happening, all these things, you know, and people are shouting, and the government have to bend. So same way, Pilate bent down to the shouts of the temple priest, and then he said, fed up with them, here is Jesus, then treat him according to your law. So he handed him over to the Jesus, and Jesus then was badly beaten. So cruelly beaten that Peter, his bosom friend, he said, I don't know this man, because once born people are frightened of corporal punishment. Twice born people, they wriggle their way. They don't bother, they don't get caught. So, like Judas Iscariot, you know. So, then Jesus was so brutally beaten, then he pretends that he can't carry the cross to see if there's any merciful person in Jerusalem who will come forward to help him. Nobody came. Then my Simon, a foreigner, he came forward and helped him, not frightened of the temple high priest. So there are much more you can learn. All these things are there in here. You can't find it in the books. You have to dig it here. This is the mine of his word. And you have to dig it. Remember that Christ is the Son of Elohim, the middle candle of the menorah. So here is the menorah. So Jesus was the Son of Yahweh. This is the creation of Yahweh. These are our physical body. Three social, ecumenical, political affairs. Some are holy, some are evil. A middle candle is of Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. So the soul from our supernatural father comes into these parts to make them living. So soul is the supernatural self. And it comes from here. That is where Jesus took them in the above, which is the palace of our supernatural father, where soul counts, not the physical body. That's why we have one father. We exercise love called agape. So this is the Christ is the son of this one, middle candle. And Yahweh is the creation of this one. So Jesus' Hebrew name is Yeshua, made of Yah from Yahweh. Shua or Shiva means the primal Adam. So Jesus was the firstborn of Yahweh, the second Adam, and Mary was surrogate mother, and Joseph foster father. That's why Jesus addressed Mary as woman and not as mother. So hope it make clear, and it's when you preach gospel, It is a fountain here. And you can keep on talking and talking. Sorry for this lengthy video.